How excited are you? This is a one-on-one niyo po with your daughter.
I'm more excited for her kasi I want to see how she's going to do or how she's gonna handle it.
Kinakabahan naman ako sa mga tatanungin niya sa akin.
Ayaw daw niya kasi kakabahan siya.
So, na-realize ko rin na I haven't asked her some of the questions na nakita ko doon.
We talk about anything, no matter how controversial, how complicated, or how taboo it is into other families.
Pero for me, feeling ko meron din ako mga new things na malalaman and I guess matututunan.
Are you ready? I'm ready.
So is this awkward for you too?
No.
Okay. So I just wanted to know, feeling ko I asked you this before, pero hindi ko maalala what you answered. Mm-hmm. Before ka nag-artista, because you were an artista since you were 9 years old.
Nine years old.
So before that, or did you have an original dream na you wanted to be other than being an artista, or before you even considered being
an
artista?
Wow, Kyla, I was what? From 1 to 8 years, 1 to 9 yeah. years old. Syempre, yung mga dreams ko, yung mga dreams na puro kalokohan pa. Like, there was a time I wanted to be a female James Bond. Dahil sa mga gadgets. Then, I wanted to be a marine biologist because yeah. I was so interested in sharks and in life underwater. But, syempre, you know, at that age, wasn't really serious. At saka, of yeah. course, nung sinabi nila sa akin that you'd have to dive underwater, ay, ayoko na. Natakot ako sa shark, no?
Pero throughout the years, you never considered taking on a different path?
Well, I did study. I wanted to become a psychologist. But then after a while, pag winay mo, pag minanage mo yung expectations at yung kaya, I realized that first, when I started school again, I had not been in school for 19 years.
Yeah.
So, wow, math was crazy. Yung ang dami pala. Tapos, 18 units yata yun, or 21 units yung wow, that was driving me crazy. Kasi sleep, work, and then I had just separated. So, I was taking care of you kids yeah. also. So, parang after a while, kaya yung Tita Jelly mo sabi niya, hello. So, oo nga naman. Tama nga naman siya. I can't do everything. Yeah. So, saan ka muna? You go with what's doable.
Looking back, because you started so young at 9 years old, do you have any regrets or do you ever look back and think, oh, you know what, I could have done this kung hindi ako artista? Or do you have regrets being a child star or starting so young?
It's not regrets. Sometimes iniisip ko, if at, let's say, 16, I had thought things out more,
yeah.
would I have wanted to do something else? Would I have wanted to really stop and finish studies? Anong gagawin ko? What would I have been? So those things, pag naiisip ko, natural lang naman yun. But it's only in passing because, you know, after I do a good job, let's say I do a good job, I realize na, wow, yeah, this is really what I want to do. I mean, I'm happy with what I'm doing. I cannot picture myself doing anything else.
So 44 years in the industry, oh wow, that's more than 4 decades of being an artista. What do you hate the most about being an artista?
It's not hate, as in hate. It's too strong a word. Kasi hindi naman ako talaga very public person. So the only thing that I wish was a little different was if I had complete privacy when I'm not working. But I learned to cope with it. Mas mahirap when you're older, ah. Kasi when you're younger, you don't think of it so much kasi wala naman nagbago sa ginagawa ko noon. Like, we would, mommy and I would go to the grocery. I would go to wherever they take me. It doesn't matter where we were. Divisoria, wherever.
Yeah.
Hindi siya nagmamatter. And you know, mommy always said, pag may magpapapicture, wala kang choice, papapicture ka, ganun. So, I mean, that was just it. I think it bothered me more when all the other private things came in, like things that happened in your marriage, in my marriage life, in my love life. So, yeah. Syempre, yun lang naman yun. Other than that, it's what comes with your being an artista.
And the chismis. Also, I'm assuming.
Chismis, oh, because for a while, that chismis affected me also.
Yeah.
Pero ngayon kasi parang, siguro, having been through it too many times, parang, okay, whatever.
Chismis is a part of being an artista also, because it happens, di ba?
Mm.
Parang hindi mo na rin siya maiiwasan, just like not really having privacy is part of being a public figure. Mm. How did you handle intriga before when you were younger? And how do you compare it to how you handle it now that, of course, you're much more mature?
Alam mo, what's weird is when you're a child star, wala naman masyadong intriga. Except that there was a rivalry because I had a competing show.
Mm.
We did movies together, si Julie Vega, and then they would... Nung una, ganun lang yung chismis. Friends ba talaga kayo? O mag-aaway ba talaga
pero
kayo?
Pero hindi naman to the point na they pit you guys together against each other.
Eh, hindi yung may iwasan yun, Kyla. Because
wow.
It's part of rivalry. Because we work together. Pero our shows competed against each other. And we were friends. We were fine. So everybody else was the one putting these thoughts in our mind. Pero kami, okay kami.
Mm.
And then after a while, syempre, nung tumada ka ng konti, nung nagka-love life, na-chismis ka ng buntis, na-chismis ka ng ganito, ganyan-ganyan. Of course, it affected me because it affected mommy and daddy.
Yeah.
Syempre, sila yung naapektuhan. Pero, naapektuhan ako ng konti. Pero parang, hindi masyado kasi, kung hindi totoo, hindi totoo. Diba? Why be affected by something that's not true?
Right.
Oh, ikaw, so which of my movies have you watched? Hindi ko na maalala kung alin na na-watch niyo.
Alam mo ma, kasi I feel like you never really told us to watch it. Na parang hindi mo naman siya talagang pinipresenta na, o panoorin yung movie ko ah.
Kasi nakakahiya kaya. Alam mo,
never
mo
yung ginawa.
Oh, watch me.
Never mo yung ginawa. But because we love horror movies, and you did so many, horror movies, and you're known for yung anak ni Janice, Chanak talaga yung name ng movie. Okay. And then you did Shake, Rattle, and Roll. Yun yung mga napanood namin.
So, ano yung favorite nyo? Which Shake, Rattle, and Roll?
The one with the ring.
With the ring? With
yeah,
Eric
the
Kison.
One with the ring, okay. And then yung Prejudice. We
okay.
Watched both. And then I would say I really liked Last Viewing.
Okay.
Because yeah. I feel like I was a bit older na then when you did that and when we watched it in the theater. So parang I guess I appreciated it more seeing you in that movie because mas naintindihan ko na like, wow, my mom can actually do all of this. Like, this is what she does for a living. Parang this is really cool. Compared to before when we were younger, when we'd see on TV, we wouldn't really understand what's going on, diba?
So did you get teased? Did people call you anak ni Janice? Did
yeah.
your friends call you that?
No, honestly, yung friends ko, hindi nila alam kung
ay,
bakit.
Ay, kasi pareho kayong generation.
Yeah, it was more of my teachers that did that to me. Tapos parang, yung mga klase ko, syempre, tiyana ka pala eh, gaganoon nila. Tapos hindi ko rin naman naiintindihan kung bakit yung time na yun. There's this one experience nung college ako. Yung professor ko, so syempre nagpapakilala isa-isa, di ba? So turn ko na magpakilala. So you stand up, you say your name, age, ganyan. So binuo ko yung name ko. Kasi ganoon naman sa school eh, di ba? You have to say your full name kasi yun yung nakasulat sa attendance. Sabi niya sa akin, ha? Anak ko ni Janice? Sabi ko, opo. Ha? Chanak! Gumanon siya sa harapan ng lahat ng mga kakalase ko. I was in college ah. So, lahat sila nagtawanan. Sabi ko, oh my God, nakakahiya to. Kasi in front of everybody, sabi talaga, ah, Chanak. And of course, di naman nila alam kung bakit, di ba? So, yeah, we used to get teased a lot. So, what was the first thought that came into your mind when you found out na mag-artista ako?
Siyempre, nagulat ako ng konti. Because,
yeah, hey, nagulat
ako,
talaga.
Siyempre naman. Magugulat ako kasi parang nabigla ako na, oh, you didn't even tell me.
Yeah.
But,
yeah.
Hindi ako galit because that's what you chose to do. It was just more of a gulat. Oh, you didn't tell me.
Yeah.
So medyo nakakashock lang ng konti. But then, yun in a way, I'm actually proud. I'm actually proud because you could have gone to me and I could have tried to do something about it.
Right.
Pero nung surprise, syempre, after the initial reaction of shock and medyo nagalit ng very light.
Medyo ano, bad timing din kasi ako nung talagi. Kasi patulog ka na nun.
Ano mo pali?
So, mali na naman talaga yung timing ko.
Oh, may ilag yung timing.
But I guess then, I just couldn't keep it any longer. So.
Pero okay naman. Yeah. So, I think after the initial reaction ng nagalit ng very lightly, okay naman.
Pero before kasi, when we were younger, you would always say na, huwag na kayo mag-artista. What was the reason behind that?
Because I was worried na hindi nyo kayanin yung lack of privacy.
That's bad.
Yun lang naman. You know, I was always hoping that you'd do something else, something na kayo talaga yung may gusto. Because ang iniisip ko lagi is, syempre, dahil artista yung mami nyo, yung daddy nyo, yung tita nyo, ang si Ariel, alam ko may mga expectation kaagad people from show business or yung mga tao, they would immediately expect you to be artistas. And you might get pushed into something na hindi nyo naman talaga gusto, all because of pressure, peer pressure.
Yeah.
Diba? So yun lang naman. But then, syempre, I wanted you to do something different. Diba? Pero... Yeah. As I was growing older, and you guys are growing older na rin, naisip ko, di ko naman mapipigil yan eh. I mean, if that's what you wanted to do, naturally, you'd think of that kasi artista kami eh. Yeah. As you were growing up, yun ang nakikita yung ginagawa namin. I hear so many stories of people being pushed into becoming something, to studying for something, and yet hindi naman yun yung gusto nila.
Yeah.
Diba? Unang-una, sayang ang time. Sayang ang effort. Sayang ang money. Might as well get into something that you actually want to do.
Right. That's so true. And actually, I'm grateful that you weren't that kind of parent kasi binigyan mo naman talaga kami ng panahon to really discover what it is we wanted to do.
And the freedom to do that.
And the freedom to do it, which is probably why I entered so late din kasi late ko rin talaga gustong subukan or late ko rin talaga na-realize na parang tumatanda na ako. And ayokong tumanda na hindi ko man lang tinry. And then true enough, it was a good decision kasi I'm passionate about it now, di ba? So, if hindi ko sinubukan, I would have never known.
Crazily passionate.
Yeah. Having said that, you know, I'm starting my career now. I've done a couple of things. Mm-hmm. How did you feel? We don't talk about it kasi actually, mas ako rin. Parang kinakabahan ako sa mga comments mo or nakakonscious lang siguro ako, so I never ask you. But how did you feel the first time you watched it?
I think I wanted to know more how you were going to do. It's not about how I felt. I wanted to know more how you were going to do. Pero
so
nakita naman kitang you were doing well, okay na ako. Okay na ako doon. Because I knew immediately that you'd be able to take care of yourself. Kasi if sa umpisa pala, I do not expect you to be fantastic. Kasi you're starting. Siyempre, kahit naman ako nung nag-uumpisa ako, oh my God, I was probably terrible. Hello?
Wala pa. Emotional na ako. Wala ko.
Akala ko ba tatawa ka lang?
Oo nga eh. Tumatawa ako din eh. Wait.
Ay, yun lang naman yun. But when I saw you doing well, okay na ako. Because I know you do well. And I know that if I keep on saying something, baka ma-pressure ka ng ma-pressure. Kasi diba sabi ko naman sa'yo, you have to be ready for what people will say, bad, good.
It's true.
Diba? Eh, you have to be ready for it. Pinasok mo to, gusto mo mag-artist eh.
Yeah.
Diba? I remember even when Ina started, sinabi ko naman sa inyo na, guys, eto yung mga pwedeng mangyari. Pwede kayong mapagalitan ng director. Do not expect me to come running and saying, uy, wag niyo mapagalitan yan. I can't do that. Because I had my share of that. I wanted you to experience everything so that you learn to treasure it more.
So true.
And I did not want to keep on pushing Kasi ayokong makarinig at sabihin nila, oh, kaya naman yan ano, kasi anak ni James yan, or anak ni John yan. Yeah. I didn't want that. I wanted you to make a name for yourself on your own. So yeah. That, di ba pagka, uy, pag nakita mo yung, uy, sabi nila ang galing ko, or let's say you receive an award and you get credit for it, mas masarap sa feeling that you did it on your own without mom and dad's help.
Totoo.
So ano ba talaga? Conscious effort on your part na wag mag-artista in the how many years?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm gonna be honest. It was a conscious effort for me not to do it. Maybe because, yun nga, parang nung time na yun kasi, hindi ko pa alam kung ano talaga yung gusto kong gawin eh. And I just wanted to have that time to really explore and live my life. So I could find out what it is that I wanted to do. Mm-hmm. And also, I guess, a rebellious part of me also just didn't want to become sure. What everyone was expecting me to be.
Pero di ba nagkaroon ka ng short stint, hosting stint? You did little hosting stints for ASAP?
Yeah! Nung 17 ako, di ba? Mm-hmm. ASAP had ASAP Chill Out. So, nandun si Kuya Robbie, Ate Megan, Young JV, me, and then they would also get like a guest every week, a different guest host every week. So
di mo naisip noon that maybe this should be the start of a...
Honestly, nung time na yun, hindi. Because I was so nervous every week.
You're always
I was so nervous every week, and then I was so shy. Di ko alam kung paano ko kakausapin yung mga guests namin. Sobrang nahihiya talaga ako. And I was barely talking.
So were you like that during your first day of shooting?
Yeah. Wala akong masyadong kinakausap. You should ask them. Talagang wala. You'll barely hear anything from me. Talaga. Nung time na yun. Pero yun nga, grateful lang ako na yung cast sobrang gaan kasama. They were all super welcoming to me. And they were so warm and really nice. Generous din sila sa advice, so it made me feel comfortable kaagad. And kahit yung production gaano na nakatrabaho, and they all super welcomed me. They didn't
make you feel
make
any different.
Make me feel like any different or like a newbie or anything. So yeah, super grateful na yun yung naging first experience ko.
So who's your showbiz crush?
You already know it.
Yes.
Jericho Rosales, my forever showbiz crush.
Sana mo gusto mo kay Jericho. I haven't worked with Jericho. I haven't worked with him.
I haven't met him. Wait. And then, briefly lang pala, parang before, parang dumaan lang siya. And then, ganyan. Because I find him so charming. Na, although hindi ko naman siya kilala personally. Feeling ko lang charming siya. And then, wala, nagugupuhin lang ako sa kanya. Parang, he's so cool, tapos may pagka-charming nga siya, and he seems so down to earth, ganyan.
Oo, kinikilig nga siya pagka nang si Jericho na yun dyan.
So, let's go on a different topic.
Okay.
How old were you when you had your first boyfriend?
I was 14.
14?
Oo, di ba sinabi ko yun sa inyo?
14 nga pala. Come to think of it now, parang ang bata nga ng 14.
Alam mo, pag inisip mo, it may not sound parang, it may not sound as ano, pero oo, bata nga ng 14. Syempre, when I had all of you,
yeah.
Syempre, oo nga, ang bata ng 14.
Pero I mean, si Ate was 14.
Yeah, exactly, that's why I told you guys, na 14 din naman ako when I had my first boyfriend.
That's why I guess you were more understanding and a bit more lenient during that time because you know what it's like to have a boyfriend at that age.
No, it's not that. It's just that pigil ako ng pigil. Gagawin nyo din naman, di ba? So what's the point, di ba? You choose your battles. Piliin mo yung battles. You can't complain about everything kasi kung hindi, world war sa bahay natin. So that's why you choose the things that you will say yes to, what you will say no to.
Yeah.
At sa tingin mo ba, had I said no, or if I complained, may magbabago?
Yeah, hindi.
Wala, di ba?
Yeah.
So, di ba?
So, 14, how did mommy react? Or did you tell her right away that you had a boyfriend?
I told my mom, mommy and I never really wala naman kami masyadong sikreto at that point. Kasi she also wanted to have a close relationship. And dahil nga babae, babae kami pareho ni Tita Jay. She wanted to make sure that she had an actual relationship where we could tell each other things. It was more daddy who had a hesitation. Reaction.
Right.
Siyempre,
what was daddy's reaction? I actually never asked him that, did.
I think lightly angry. Siyempre, kasi daughter, first daughter. Siyempre ganun, it's natural.
Do you think that maybe because nung time na yun, nag-aartista ka na, that maybe they felt like it was inevitable? Or were they more open to the idea because you had been in showbiz since 9 years old?
Parents are never open to the idea of their children having girlfriends or boyfriends. It's never an open, it's never a welcome thought, mm-hmm. but it is inevitable, inevitable, fear you.
So how did you react when you found out that I had a boyfriend?
You don't remember. Ikaw nga yung tanong ko. How did I react?
Well, actually, kasi we always talk naman and I don't think I ever really hid those things from you. So it wasn't a big announcement when I had to tell you I had a boyfriend, because you already knew I was seeing somebody, eh. Di ba? Hmm. Kaya wala namang big reaction.
Tsaka alam ko rin, alam ko naman na may MUs and may ano, so parang, okay. So, what's new?
Yeah, true.
Di ba?
So, which of my exes did you like the most?
Nan, kasi exes na sila eh. Di ba? So bakit ko mo sila ilalike? Ex na eh. Wala nang point. It won't matter.
Kawawa sila pag napanood nila to. Joke lang.
Hindi naman. You know, ex na. So yeah. Parang, bakit pa natin pag-uusapan?
Yeah. Ito na nga, so pag-uusapan na natin yung ex mo.
Oh, ex ko, okay.
So what was the real, ito, I'm sure I've never asked you this, and I never thought to really ask you, but what was the real reason kung bakit kayo naghiwalay ni Tito Aga? And what would you have done differently back then?
I wouldn't have done anything differently because maybe part of the reason why things didn't work out for us was we were 18. You know, at that time, I thought, I knew it. I thought we were all responsible enough. Yeah. Pero syempre, when I had you guys, pag inisip mo yung 18, oh my God, I had a child when I was 18. So one of the reasons was because, not because I got pregnant.
Yeah.
But because we didn't agree on things, because at some point, he wanted to get married. And noong una, it was, wow, Rosie, parang ang saya, going to get married. Then I had time to think about it because, of course, mommy and daddy explained to me what marriage would entail. Mm-hmm. Siyempre, napaisip din ako, tama naman, oo nga naman, 18?
Yeah.
Wow, may teen pa sa dulo. Diba? So sabi ko, started on the wrong foot, we can't keep on doing things wrongly. So maybe marriage was not the thing. And you know, I mean, we were okay with it for a while, but things started to fail.
Yeah.
Because you know, having a child is really a great responsibility. To be responsible for another person, another life, it's not easy. So, yun lang naman, because at some point, we saw ourselves on different paths. Iba na yung iniisip namin pareho. So, alam mo na na, dun pa lang, hindi na siya mag-work. So, pagka hindi na mag-work, huwag na ibilit.
We talked about your breakup with Tito Aga. Mm-hmm. And you were pregnant with Kuya at 18. Mm-hmm. How did you feel being pregnant at that age? And how did it change your life during that time?
I don't remember if I was scared. You know, that's the thing, I don't remember if I was scared. I think I was more decidido.
Okay.
I was more decided that to continue with the pregnancy and to raise Luigi and to have a child, kasi it's there. you can't change that anymore. So it's an eye-opener because all of a sudden, you transform into being a teenager to a mom.
Yeah.
And you have to start adulting. Your decisions will change. Every decision from there on will not just involve you, it will involve another person. And that would be Luigi. So I just knew I had to work harder. I had to continue working.
Did it affect, like, I don't know, your image or after the roles that you got?
So may awkward stage then because you're not a child and you're not an adult. Mm-hmm. So you're sort of in between.
In the middle.
And even roles had a problem doon sa ganong age, ha? Kasi parang we don't know kung saan ka ba, mother role ka na ba or ano. And when I became a parent, I took on mother roles immediately. Mm. So which was advantageous for me because hindi ako natagalan doon sa awkward stage. Agad-agad, nakapag-shift ako ng roles. Wow. Which gave me a lot more opportunities, I would like to think. It gave me a lot more opportunities. Oo, siguro hindi ka na pwede sa mga love team, but that was better for me kasi at least I already had a direction. I already knew what na pwede ko nang i-accept yung ganung roles. Because yeah. I gave birth to Luigi at 18. At 19, I was already doing mother roles.
Wow.
So, di ba, at least yung transition ko, mabilis. Mahirap ba to have artista parents?
Yes and no. Yes, because, you know, you guys are public figures. Are public figures. And so there are a lot of things na alam ng mga tao na parang, how did you guys know about that? Yung mga private stuff that come out, and it's just weird when people ask you about it and it's such a personal thing.
I remember that when you guys were younger and we would go somewhere and then people would ask to take a picture, kayo ni Moira ang hilig niyo sumimangot.
Yeah. Yeah. Weird eh, kasi parang I feel like it's more of, it's not really them wanting to take pictures, it's more of what they say na sobrang negative. Like they would make these comments na in a normal conversation, di mo naman sasabihin.
Okay.
Na parang, and then you just have to smile and, you know, accept it. Na parang I found it really odd na parang they would say that to you. Or to dad, tapos parang wala lang nangyari. Pero kung normal na situation yun, for example, yung kami ng classmate ko, ginanun ko siya, baka nasapak na ako nun, di ba?
So, kanino ko mas nagmana? Sa akin o sa tatay mo?
Sa'yo.
Good sa'yo. Answer.
I think even
very
you,
good answer.
I think if I had asked you the same thing, you would say.
Siyempre, I will say, ano yung namana mo sa akin? Or do you not want to answer the question because your dad might watch this?
No, hindi, okay lang. Wait, let me think. Feeling ko, it's because I spent so much time with you.
Okay.
Even when I was younger, kasi they were going to school, hindi pa ako, tapos baby pa si Yuan. So you would always take me everywhere, diba? Even in school, you would take me with you, diba? So feeling ko maybe because of that, yung mga iba mong traits nakuha ko din.
Okay. I hope it's the good ones.
I'm a bit of a nagger. That's one. So kila Moy, kila Ate, diba? Kay Yuan, I nag them.
So nagger ako.
Yeah.
Okay, fine.
Pero I think it's not necessarily a bad thing. It can be a good thing also.
It's a parent thing.
Yeah, pero yun nga, I guess yung pagiging ate type personality ko, maybe I got it from you.
Pwede.
Kasi si Moy at si Ate would always say that. Parang si Mama, they would always say that. So, feeling ko yun. Feeling ko baka yun naman.
Okay. Eh, yun nakuha mo sa tatay mo.
My height, my forehead. I guess si dad kasi likes making jokes. Palibaro siyang tao, and I think na medyo may pagkaganon din ako. And that's how we get along, siguro. Lagi kami nag-aasaran, so.
Saka yung lagi nakasimangot.
Lagi nakasimangot? Sa kanya ko ba nakuha yun?
Malamang. Hindi mo sa akin nakuha yun. Definitely, hindi mo sa akin nakuha yun.
I think that's debatable. Joke lang. But if ever in the future, you know, someday, are you willing to work with Tito Aga or Dad again in a movie or like maybe in a soap?
Aga, yes, I would be open to working with Aga. Your dad, no.
Why not?
Alam mo kasi, hindi kami naging mag-asawa ni Aga.
Okay.
So, it's different. The relationship is different. It's different with your dad. Kasi naging mag-asawa kami. Mm-hmm. Okay, yung disagreements namin were not tiny disagreements.
Right.
Okay, the reason for us separating, it's not a tiny thing. It's not just a disagreement. So many hurtful things, so many hurtful words have already been exchanged. And there's a reason why we're not exactly friends.
Yeah. Diba? And I think,
No, it's not gonna work.
Yeah.
Everything that has happened between both of us, we might be an inconvenience to the people that we are working with and working for.
Okay.
So, baka maging problema kami. So, wag na lang kami maging problema at all. And you know, we're fine, we're civil. You're grown-ups. If you need anything, you can go straight to him. So, diba?
Better safe than sorry.
I mean, let's reserve those things for like when you guys get married and we really have to be in one room together.
Right.
So, let's reserve it for those occasions. What was your initial reaction? Because you were how young when we separated?
I was 4 ba? 5.
96 ka pinanganak, so 5 lang.
Yeah, 5. Mm. Honestly, initial reaction, I don't remember. Because I was so young when it happened that processing it happened years after
that. So when did you actually process it?
I guess at first, it was more of just, I was used to the setup.
Okay.
Kasi I was so young, wala naman akong alam, diba? So, still difficult to talk about. Anyway, siguro grade school na ako, mga grade 4, 5, ganyan. Tagal na, kasi I don't think I really thought about it that much because I was so young when it happened and I was so used to the routine na the setup, yung he wasn't living with us and we would see him every once in a while lang, na it just felt normal for me. And then, syempre, growing up and having a better understanding of things, doon ko lang siya talaga na process.
Okay, do you still feel bad about it now?
No. I guess I'm just emotional about it because I haven't thought about how I was feeling in a long time about that. And syempre, when you're used to a setup like that, di mo naman na siya iniisip palagi kasi sanay ka na, di ba? So, it doesn't really cross my mind that much anymore. I don't feel bad about it. Honestly, we're good. We've always been okay. And our relationship with him naman is great now. So, it doesn't really matter anymore because it's been so long already. Pero siguro when I just look back at how I was feeling then, it's hard to go back.
Have you processed it already?
Yeah, I feel like now that I'm an adult and I understand you both better, being married at that age, I can't even imagine. I mean, I'm older right now than you guys were when you were married. So parang, I can imagine how difficult it was to navigate the relationship then, especially being in the entertainment industry where everything is so public and having to deal with separating. In the public, I must have been extremely difficult. So parang I felt like when you were processing it, we were also doing it at the same time. So, grabe, that must have been super hard for you. And syempre, when I think about it now, it hurts me because kasi nga mas broad na yung understanding ko ngayon. So if I can just imagine what you went through, nasasaktan ako, syempre.
Oo.
Diba?
Oo. Sa akin naman, on my part naman kasi, before I had been through much more prior to the decision of separating than after. because parang na-use up na lahat ng pain ko, lahat ng pain capacity ko and tears ko parang nagamit na the whole process of how things got to separating.
Yeah.
So by the time I decided, I was calm.
Yeah.
I was ready for anything. That's why it was more on you. And I figured your recovery, the way your kids will recover, will depend on how I recovered. Kasi kung nakita niyo ako na everyday, umiiyak, or troubled, or yung hilo, or yung parang nababaliw, dun kayo mas mahihirapan. And I wanted to make sure that I would be okay.
Yeah.
Pag humarap na ako sa inyo, para ang i-worry ko na lang kayo, hindi na yung sarili ko.
I guess that's why then it took a while. Kasi we didn't see you. We barely saw you breaking down in front of us. So, syempre, ang iniisip namin nun, everything is okay, di ba? Kasi nga, we were young, di ba? We were really young. We didn't know how deep it was, or you know what the gravity of the situation was at that time. That's probably why it took so long then for me, I can only speak for myself, to process it. Is because syempre ngayon na mas matanda na ako, dun ko lang na-realize na wow, mama must have been really going through it then, you know, kasi yun lang eh, that's the only way for me to really think about it.
That's when you will truly understand naman talaga.
Yeah,
diba? But I wanted to be honest with all of you. I didn't want to exclude you from the decision.
Yeah. And you were.
Because buhay niyo rin yan eh.
Yeah.
Diba? I cannot say na, oh, let's not involve the children. No. They're involved already.
Yeah.
That's why it was important for me to immediately tell you and be honest with all of you.
Yeah.
So, the recovery period starts kaagad. Mm-hmm. Di na mag-iintay ng matagal.
Yeah. How did your separation with Dad change your perspective on love? And do you see yourself getting married again?
I think after your dad, di naman nag-change kaagad yung perception ko sa love. Because, siguro kasi bata pa ako, so bata-bata pa ako. So hindi pa naman talaga nag-change yung perspective ko sa love. And I did have a relationship after. At some point, yes, I still wanted to get married. Pero ngayon, if you're going to ask me, now is a different time. Parang feeling ko, okay na ako. Okay na ako. Parang I have nothing more to prove when it comes to relationships. First, you know, I've had how many relationships? Nag-asawa na ako, nahiwalay na ako, I have kids already, I have grandkids already. I have nothing more to prove. And I've been independent for so long na I like this independence.
Yeah.
I really like this. So I'm good.
But if you were to have a next relationship, because we never know, and of course, let's not close that door, diba?
Okay.
What would you want, or what are the things na you need to tick off your list muna before getting into that relationship?
Masyadong serious yan. Balik tayo sa who do you want?
Who do you want na lang, sige.
Oh, you're so donkey.
Well, si Hyunbin pa lang naman ang married, di ba?
Si Hyunbin, okay lang ako.
Okay lang.
Supportive ako. Okay. Either Lee Minho or Song Joong Ki.
So, Song Joong Ki, if you're watching, my mom is single and available. Papayag ako maging stepdad ko siya.
Papayag ka naman.
Papayag naman ako.
Baka siya hindi po bayad.
Kailangan mag-Korean lessons ka muna, ma. Para naman, pwede kayo mag-usap, di ba?
No, but that's just for fun. Wala, alam mo, hindi ko na talaga iniisip. That's why I don't think of what list would I have, or what would be the requirements. Kasi I really don't think about it anymore. Do you see yourself getting married?
Right now, 50-50.
Okay.
Kasi siguro I'm not at a point in my life where I'm really seriously thinking about it yet. Maybe I'm just not there.
May when ka na ba? May age ka na ba or may when or wala pa rin?
Hindi ko pa talaga siya naiisip eh, honestly. Kasi I'm just not fully there.
No, because you're starting something again. So you're still building yourself up. Okay lang naman.
Parang marami pa akong gustong gawin muna before I consider a commitment like that.
So would you work with me?
Huh?
Would you work with me?
When muna. Kasi kung tomorrow na, wag muna.
Oh, but we're together now. We're working together now.
Siguro, you know, so many people have already asked me that. So many people. And I always tell you na, I would love to work with you, but not right now. Parang I feel like I need a couple of years of experience muna before I would be fully comfortable working with you.
Actually, ako rin, I don't like to work with you yet. Do you know why?
Are you gonna be frustrated, Jo?
No! Kasi mapapressure ka.
Yeah.
And you get crazy when you're pressured.
Yeah. And I'd have to build my confidence muna in what I'm doing before I'll be able to work with you properly. Otherwise, baka mag-collapse na lang ako. So, huwag muna. Huwag muna ngayon. Let's save it for another time. Siguro in the next few years pa.
So, if you were to give me a grade as a parent,
okay,
for my performance as your mother,
yeah,
from 1 to 10, syempre yung 10 ang highest.
Yeah.
Sige, bigyan mo nga ako ng number. Syempre, anong magiging grade ko?
Ano, mga 9.5.
Uy, wow.
Yeah, 9.5. Ma, 0.5 na lang, 10 na yun, ha?
Hindi ako nagreklamo. Parang nagulat naman ako na naabot ako sa 9.5.
Oo naman, kasi, you know, I feel like perfection is unattainable.
Of course
not. Diba? Especially, I feel, when it comes to parenting. Obviously, I'm not a parent, so I wouldn't know. But given that you had us at such a young age, and given what you went through, I feel like you've done an awesome job.
9.5, guys.
Okay.
9.5.
So, what advice would you give a newbie like me in the industry in terms of surviving in this industry, or it could also be acting advice? Yeah.
One, be yourself.
Yeah.
Stay true to yourself. Then second, always do your best. If your best is not okay with them, at least you did your best.
I think you also instill in us to be very professional. Mm-hmm. Punctual, and also to treat everybody with respect.
Yes.
That's what I always say when people ask me also. Kasi yun yung mga talagang tumatak sa akin, the advice that you give. Given that you're 44 years in this industry already, how much longer do you think you're going to be doing this? And do you see yourself retiring anytime soon, or do you have like an age in your mind na gusto mong mag-retire?
I don't really think of retiring. Slowing down, yes. But balik tayo doon sa usapan natin kanina. I can't picture myself doing anything else.
Yeah.
I mean, minsan iniisip ko, ano kaya kung mag-farming na lang ako?
Yeah.
Pagkaganoon ka, talaga? Parang hindi naman.
Yeah.
So, not retire, but slow down.
Do you have like a certain age na parang, okay, ito na yung time na magsuslow down ako?
Alam mo, hindi rin. Kasi, ang hirap to put a time on something that you love doing.
Yeah.
Mahirap talaga maglagay ng time. Kasi, what if sabihin ko, sige, next week, break muna ako for 2 years. Tapos doon sa time frame na yon, you're given a project that's really nice.
Yeah.
So, di ba, parang di na lang. Okay, when I feel like slowing down, let's say, I feel like slowing down, then I'll slow down now. And then if I want to go back to it again, go back to it, di ba?
So now that we're done with the personal questions, this is just like a fun, parang fast talk,
okay,
just so we can gauge how well we know each other and maybe how similar we are to each other. How do you feel about... Oh, by the way, these questions, yes or no lang is sagot.
Okay.
It's up to you if you're gonna say why, but for me, I'm just gonna say yes or no.
ako magtatanong, legalized divorce in the Philippines?
Yes.
Why?
I feel like we all deserve a better chance at happiness and something that I'm sure you can relate to that.
No, yes. And, ako, yes na yes ako dyan. Yes na yes ako because of the benefits yes. pag divorce.
Yeah.
I think single mothers need to be protected more because being a single parent. Because immediately, pagka naghiwalay kayo, normally the children go to their parents until they are of legal age when they can choose who to stay with.
Yeah.
Pero syempre, like, I had 5 kids with me. It was hard. Child support.
Yeah.
It was hard with all of that.
And the process of the annulment took so long.
Exactly.
And was so expensive, which is one of the reasons why I want it to be legalized, because I feel like there should be an easier way to get a better chance at happiness.
And a second chance.
And a second chance, diba? And I feel like also with marriages that are so toxic already, or with domestic violence, that there should be an easier way out of that. So, yeah.
Okay.
Mandatory sex education.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. I think it's not because you teach them what to do. No, it's not that. Teach them how to protect themselves.
Yeah.
Teach them about protect themselves. It's really important.
Mm-hmm.
Yun muna. Kasi hindi rin talaga madali. We don't want unwanted pregnancies because from unwanted pregnancies comes divorce, teen marriages, hiwalay, dumadami yung ganyan. So, di ba?
Yeah.
So, yes, I think it should be taught.
Same. Same with me. I feel like it's important for young people to know how to take care of themselves and how to take care of each other. And I think consent is also a big part of sex education.
Exactly.
And I feel like it's important to be taught that. And to be given options. How about being close friends with an ex?
No, not really. Depends on the ex.
Why?
It's debatable.
Ako, hard
balik
no,
tayo dun sa sinabi ko kanina. Kasi there are many different exes.
Right.
I mean, kung ex lang, ex-boyfriend mo siya, like when you were 12, when all you did was quarrel and ano, okay lang yun. Kasi childhood na yun eh. Pero when you're much older, there are many more issues and complications.
Right.
I mean, you can be friends with one ex and not friends with the others. Really depends.
Yeah, for me, it's no. No talaga. Parang, after what you said, I was thinking, parang nga, debatable. Pero parang for me, no. I feel like it's bound to get complicated when you're close friends with an ex, so no na lang. We're doing this interview because it's Mother's Day, and I just wanted to take this opportunity to... Oh my God. to thank you for everything that you've done for us, of course. You've always been my inspiration growing up. And you really deserve so much more in the world. And my wish for you is, of course, to, you know, finally put yourself first and find true happiness. And of course, good health, that's a given. And yeah, that's really the only things that I want for you. And I love you, and thank you so much for being such an amazing mother to all of us.
Kaya ko ba? It feels weird to not be the one crying.
Yeah. Kaya ko pa ba? And also, I have a gift for you. I'm not the best gift giver, but you can count on me to give you something that you need.
Am I supposed to open it?
Yeah, you can open it.
Yeah. Oh, yes, I need
yeah.
this.
So, since you always end up losing or breaking your glasses, you have yeah. a new pair.
I need a new one.
Yeah.
Okay. Maganda. Just, maganda, diba?
Maganda.
Yeah, thank you, sweetheart. Yeah, I love you. And me, I just wish you always the best, whatever it is that you want to do. I just want you to do it well.
Yeah.
Diba? Tsaka ano? Chill. it's weird I'm the one saying chill.
Yeah.
Chill.
Okay.
That's it.
Happy Mother's Day.
With each other for
Mother's Day. Actually, akala ko, i-interviewin kami pareho. Ay, sabihin, iba yung mag-i-interview. Kahapon ko na lang ata na-realize na kami lang palang dalawa. Okay naman. Okay naman.
Yeah, ako rin. Feeling ko nung umupo na kami dito, dun lang ako kinabahan. Pero hindi naman ako kinabahan yesterday or the days before that. Kasi lagi naman kami nag-uusap ni Mama. So, parang I just thought it was going to be the same. Pero pasabog yung mga questions.
How was the experience?
Weird, kasi usually ako yung laging umiiyak. Kaya medyo weird kasi ko, ah, okay.
Actually, hindi ko, to be fair, hindi ko rin in-expect talaga na iiyak ako. Pero siguro...
Ako in-expect.
Okay, in-expect ni Mama.
Expect ko.
She's always right. She was tonight.
Ano yung tanong na pinaka-nahirapan kayo? Sagutin.
Ako wala, meron ba? Wala naman, parang wala naman. Ikaw, ano yung pinakamahirap? Ikaw yung umiyak eh.
Yeah, wala naman din.
Ikaw nga yung umiyak sa sarili mong tanong eh.
Hindi naman because it was hard, a hard question, no? I think it was more of...
You got caught in the emotions.
Yeah, yun. It was difficult to... Yun, like yung sinabi ko kanina, it was difficult to look back on.
Message niyo for mothers since Mother's Day?
Ako ang message ko is, you know, talk to your children, no matter, ask your children questions para alam niyo kung ano yung nasa isip nila so you get an idea of how your children think, what they believe in, what they... You need to get to know them, eh. By asking them questions is really the only way para makilala nyo sila. You know, ask kahit gaano ka-dangerous yung questions. Kasi sana yung mga anak natin na tayong ginugulat nila. Paminsan-minsan, sila yung gulatin natin sa mga tanong natin. Diba? Kasi ako, I've always asked my children, no matter how taboo the questions, ni tanungin mo para ni alam mo kung ano yung nasa isip nila. Hindi siya perfect, di ako perfect score, but at least you have an idea.
What mom said to all the moms out there, happy Mother's Day, and we're so grateful for you, and I hope you have, we hope you have an amazing Mother's Day.
Mothers, it's our day today, so let's relax.